Coming up, making sure your family's wealth lives on for generations. This is Regions Wealth Insights. Welcome to Regions Wealth Insights. I'm Jeremy King. Today, we're joined by Regions Private Wealth Advisor, Philip Furlong. Philip, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Jeremy. It's a pleasure to be here.
Transferring wealth from one generation to another is a lot more than just maintaining an account. There's a lot of planning involved, right?
Absolutely, Jeremy. And with that planning can come stress. It doesn't have to, but in the long run, it's worth the cost and the effort.
So tell me, Philip, when you have families in your office and they want to make sure that their financial legacy can live on, what is it that you advise them?
Yeah, this is exactly the role a wealth advisor plays. We bring the family in, we have what's called a family legacy meeting, and this is an organized collaborative process in which we bring the key decision makers of the family and the beneficiaries, if possible. We have a private meeting just to discuss what the values and the visions and the goals are for the money. Our team meets with the family and really just puts in place that written, clear plan for the future.
I imagine that has to be part of your role as well as the moderator of these meetings to help the family get on the same page. Is that correct?
Yes, exactly, Jeremy. And you know, the most important thing is to remember that there's a value and a vision from the senior members of the family that they want to see transfer to the next generation and the generation thereafter. And so the most important part is really just kind of make sure that that senior member of the family's visions and values are communicated and thoroughly followed through with.
So what are some of the specific steps that you lead families through when they are creating the plan?
First, we like to begin with a mission statement. We like to make sure that the family sits down and really thinks through where they want these assets to go, how they want to benefit the family. And this mission statement is a great place for us to pick up and begin that process. Once the mission statement's in place, it's the wealth advisor's job to follow the dialogue through the principles that the family has established in the mission statement.
Once the mission statement is in place, what are some of the questions that you discuss with families to help you develop the plan?
The first is, how do these values and these goals affect how the wealth gets transferred? Second, how do they affect inheritance plans and philanthropy? Third, what strengths does each family member have and what roles will each person play in the legacy planning process? And finally, if a family-owned business is involved or real estate, how will the sale of the family-owned business or the real estate affect these plans?
As an advisor, what else do you need in addition to the answers to those questions to help develop the detailed plan?
Several documents are necessary for this plan: a will, living will, healthcare directives, insurance documents, power of attorney designations. And once we have all those, it makes it easier for us to put these plans in place for clients.
I suppose we should point out that even once these plans are in place, really this is a plan that can evolve over time. Is that correct?
Yes. The family legacy meeting and the mission statement are always meant to be revisited. It's an ongoing process. And what we really do here is we just try to make sure that as the family grows and ages and changes, that these dynamics are kept up with and that the plan that was put in place at the beginning remains to be relevant and strong for the family as the years progress.
And I suppose that also speaks to the value of having a long-term relationship with someone who can help you as these goals might evolve over time.
Exactly. And what we see with families, there's so many changes in life. The most important process is having a wealth advisor or a team of advisors that is there with them throughout all these changes and that can quickly help implement plans and changes that are necessary.
Philip Furlong, Private Wealth Advisor with Regions Private Wealth Management, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Jeremy. It's my pleasure.
And we thank you for watching. We have more insights online to help you build, protect, and preserve your wealth. Just go to regions.com/wealth. Or if you'd like to discuss this or other topics in person, give us a call at 1-800-826-6933. And we'll see you here soon for another edition of Regions Wealth Insights.